Riding for a gold medal in the show jumping tonight for Australia after rocketing from 18th to 1st in the three-day event. Meantime, diver Michael Murphy also staged a terrific charge to finish within reach of a medal in the men's platform diving.
Murphy was among the tail-enders in the final after the early rounds, but the high standard of competition flopped with leader Alvin Killat.
Now he is out of the competition totally.
American Mark Lenzi saw the chance to snatch gold and did. Murphy also made a charge. His last dive took him to fourth place, Australia's best finish in Olympic diving for more than 50 years. Mark Kingsland added to a mounting list of fourth placings for Australia when he lost to eventual gold medalist Boardman in the pursuit. His time was 1.55 seconds behind that of the bronze medalist. Boardman's win has been upstaged by his bike. The carbon fibre frame designed by the Lotus Grand Prix racing team is said to be the hottest thing on two wheels since the penny farthing. Sprinter Gary Niewand continued his surge towards gold. He's in the semi-finals.
And that little salute that comes from Gary Niewand every time he finishes.
One of the unexpected stars of the Games, Matthew Ryan, aboard 15-year-old Kibar TikTok in a stunning endurance ride for the combined event.
And, ooh, brilliantly set.
Ryan won the test, and even though teammate Duncan Green is out with a lame horse, the Aussies are third going into tonight's show jumping. In rowing, our women's Coxless Fours were first into a final via repechage, but disaster for single sculler Andrea Koss. She overturned in her semi-final, no second chance. More disqualifications plague our sailors, but our three-man team in the Soling class is well placed for a medal. So are our basketballers back on pine with a win over Venezuela. Ahead by 20 at one stage, the Boomers had to survive a late challenge.
And in for the jam.
They won by 7.
Keogh puts up a 3. That needs to drop, and it does.
And if they beat China tonight, they can be assured of a top 3 placing in their group. A setback for the women's hockey team. They were beaten by the Germans in a surprising result.
And it's in the net.
The defending champs must now beat the hometown heroes Spain to make the finals.
Meantime, Australia is heading a move at the Olympics to have random drug testing introduced on a worldwide scale, not only during competition, but also when athletes are in training. Pressure for wider drug testing was intensified this week when swimming officials discovered that gold medalists at the pool were not being tested automatically.
After winning a bronze medal in one of the first swimming finals, South Australian breaststroker Phil Rogers was held up for 2 hours giving a urine sample to doping control officials. Rogers was amazed to see the gold and silver medalists leave unchecked. Swimming authorities were taking tests from 3 in each event, selected at random, regardless of where they finished. Australia, New Zealand and Canada argued this was inappropriate, that if the IOC laboratory was going to find evidence of performance-enhancing drugs, they would surely be found in the winners, not the losers. As a result, swimming has now fallen into line.
In many, many sports, rowing, I think track and field, certainly a large number, the first 4 place-getters in finals are always tested plus 1 random, and of course that, I guess, is the ideal.
There are 2 problems with random drugs testing worldwide. One is the cost, and the other, who's going to enforce it worldwide?